Hello everybody, welcome to our webinar with the topic Application Controller ACS. My name is Thorsten Reibel. I'm sitting here together with Jürgen Schilder and also Michael Klippan, the responsible product manager with us. He will help us or help me in answering your questions. So what is planned for today? Only one product, the Application Controller ACS. Let's say the heart of the system of Climate Echo. I introduce the component with the functions, which has to do with the web user and bucket interface, but also with the predefined and freely programmable automation functions. But then I will follow with more practical demonstration, first of all in the ETS. And then I will follow with the practical demonstration together with the web user interface. And also I will show you practically the integration or the communication to BugNet. So today, less slides, but more demonstration. Good, let's start. We are talking about the application controller. As mentioned, it's part of our Climate Echo solution, of course, covering the management and automation level. And if you go to our famous picture with a whole view to the Climate Echo solution, we are talking now about the component on the left side. So all other components were already covered in the last webinars. So the application controller with BugNet interface and some more functions. Good, I get again good feedback regarding my understanding, so I think we can continue now. So why application controller in a heating cooling system? So in a heating cooling system, HVAC system, there are some superior intelligent units required for one, at least for numerous tasks. So these functions can be, for example, any controller functionality, or I have to collect and process data, I need some mathematical function, I have to compare values, I need interfacing, in our case, BugNet and web user interface. In our Climate Echo solution, we need superior intelligence for our field devices, like the heating cooling circuit controller, like the boiler chiller interface, to have a consistent solution. And this can be done finally only in a central component with a good performance with a dedicated software behind. So this is the device for KNX twisted pair connection, of course, but you will see later also Ethernet is an important connection, but it has no physical in and outputs because in all our field devices, we have already enough inputs and outputs to operate all the functions we need. And I underline here again, the topic BugNet is a big topic, but I come to this separately. We can cover this now with this component to have a dedicated KNX BugNet interface. So to summarize, for a complete consistent solution, we need the application controller ACS and to have really a complete HVAC solution in our Climate Echo world. Yeah, looking to the first component in principle, the ACS 121, which has an integrated BugNet interface. So we are communicating to BugNet via IP in both directions and also to the web user interface. An option to operate, but also to display functions will be done via IP in both directions. I will show both in practice. To all our connected KNX devices, we communicate via twisted pair. So that is the proven communication channel, let's say, and to all the components we discussed already, like room temperature controller, the fan coil, or valve drive controller, boiler chiller interface, and the other components we have. So the version with BugNet is called ACS 121, and we have a second component, the same functionality as just mentioned regarding web user interface and communication to the other KNX devices, but without BugNet interface. So you can choose. If you don't need BugNet, you can take the ACS 111. Yeah, to have a look to all four functions we have in this component, besides the web user interface and BugNet integration. Some more words around these automation functions. So we distinguish between the so-called predefined functions. We will call it later automation specific modules. So these are functions already prepared. You can parameterize them. You can assign it to the other KNX components via group addresses to create your complete solution. So this is more or less finished, at least regarding the modules we have right now. If it does not fit to your requirements, it's still possible to use the freely programmable automation part, which is very similar to the functionality of the logic controller ABAS-121. So you will see, when I go into the ETS, we took part or in principle the ABAS capability and integrated it into the application controller, because it's a very good solution to create your own logic or further intelligent superior functions. So in principle, four different and independent functions. You don't have to use all together. If you need only in brackets a BACnet interface, that's also okay. You can use this device. Yeah, a first view to these functions I just mentioned, these predefined automation modules. Some are already shown here on the right side. So if you select out of a library, dedicated automation modules, for example, a time scheduler. You can use a trend lock recorder to record values like control value set points. You can store it graphically, but also export it to an export and an Excel sheet. For dedicated components like the boiler chiller interface or the heating cooling circuit controller, we have specific automation modules with the right software behind to run these components in the total solution properly. We have the so-called automation module with the logic of the ABAS behind. So it's a collection of different functions you can use, and everything running in the application controller, which is a, of course, decentralized solution, a very reliable piece of hardware. So it's not a PC-based intelligence you might have in other systems. And in some projects, exactly such a dedicated device for such tasks is required. And we fulfill this with this component. Yeah, a closer view to these automation-specific modules, these predefined automation modules, abbreviation is ASM. So it represents specific functionality. It can execute functions by itself or together with other modules. So you can link modules with each other. There are modules which are very simple and some more which are really intelligent. But in total, together with linking of these modules, you create your complete solution. So if you select a module, it looks later like this here, a module as a box. You can parameterize this. You have dedicated parameters. To communicate to outside, out of the component, you have group objects where you assign group addresses, of course. But for the internal connection within the application controller with other automation-specific modules, you can take can create an internal connection via the sockets. So components or modules have sockets to be linked if you want to other modules. In this case, it's only the module value. The value is a data point in principle I would like to assign to a group address and via the group object to be connected to any other KNX device. So, but I show it a bit practically directly in the ETS to get a bit more detailed impression how it works. Yeah, and then this further part, which is really important. Also here you see something later, the web user interface. So the web user interface is automatically created based on your selected automation modules. Yeah, so for each module, you have a dedicated web user view later, but not only a view, also the option to see actual values or to change any values, to take action, let's say. It depends on your programming. So nothing has to be done to create, for example, here such a room modulator in the web user interface with the functions you have selected. In this case, yeah, a lot of functions, radiator and split unit and so on. You assign maybe internally via linking view, other ASMs to have function, and finally via group objects, group addresses to the real KNX devices, and then you have your function more or less visualized. But be careful, it's not a complete freely programmable visualization. It's a web user interface to have to cover most of the requirements, the easy and fast and cost-efficient way, but it cannot replace a complete superior visualization like a SCADA or a BMS system. It's not the task, but for some smaller projects, it might be sufficient. Very interesting for any maintenance, for any commissioning, where you have to test something. And it's a very easy assess for anybody. Yeah, if you give the person access to this, he can have a look into different rooms or different status information and can react on this. Yeah, and to connect to such a web user interface in the device, it's very simple. You need only a browser and the IP address of this application controller, which is easy to identify and easy to assess, you will see. Yeah, later in the web user interfaces, we see also these ASMs as blocks, first of all, where already some values will be visible, but some of these ASMs has the option to be opened. So you click on these modules and then a further view, a further screen screen will be opened with some more detailed information. There are different, let me say, views, of course, available depending on the module you have selected. But also here you will see later directly in practice how it looks like with different ASMs I have already created in my example project I have running here. Yeah, and a further big topic is the integration of the interface to BugNet. BugNet is a further protocol in building automation, coming mainly or strongly from the HVAC application, heating, ventilation, air conditioning. There are often requirements from the market in projects to have a KNX BugNet interface, which we hadn't before. And the components, the application controller, is also a BugNet interface. Yeah. So you will see also a very simple way to integrate BugNet to KNX. We have a bidirectional communication available. And you will see later, I only select, okay, this data point I would like to have as BugNet, readable only maybe, or both readable and writable. So communication in both direction, and then the job is done. So you don't have to configure. And of course, we support also these wide range of BugNet objects, which are existing in BugNet systems. So different data point types are also and then available. One function, for example, is the so-called BugNet calendar and schedule, means we have different time functions inside our application controller. You can create the following together with BugNet, that we can create a so-called BugNet calendar or scheduler. The time functions are running then in the application controller, but the change of these time functions will be done via the BugNet side. So we have reliably outsource, let's say, the time function, our application controller changes only via BugNet. This is a request from the market we can fulfill right now. So in principle, all these BugNet objects, not only, or KNX objects, not only on this both levels, but if you want also available via web user interface. So the three levels, KNX, BugNet, and web user interface, are more or less in parallel available, and you can choose in which direction from what will be sent or received. Important is the bidirectional communication is explained this way, that we can send from BugNet or can write state or values from BugNet via the application controller into KNX directly. We as KNX, together with the application controller, can provide any values, any status information from KNX as a server. So we are so-called BugNet server. So in simple words, what we are doing, we are delivering our status, our value to the main entrance of the BugNet system, notify the BugNet system something new is here for you, please take it. And then a so-called BugNet client is necessary to take it and to process it in the BugNet system, which is more or less in a complete BugNet solution standard and shouldn't be a problem. So we are a BugNet server, but not the BugNet client. This is part of the complete external BugNet solution. BugNet is also a standard, an open protocol, and also BugNet devices have to be certified. And we did this also with this component. So the application controller ACS121 is a BugNet component. And we successfully executed these so-called BTL tests. So it's a certified BugNet component already. Yeah, and to prove this, we have on our homepage, beside many more, let me say, documentation, also this conformance certificate showing that this is a real certified BugNet component. And if you want to further documents, are there available so-called BugNet testing laboratories, product listing, and the BACnet protocol implementation conformance statement. So all on our homepage. But at the end, I come to all the documents of what we have already right now. So BACnet certified product is the message here. Yeah, of course, I checked already everything around BACnet with my testing equipment here. And here, to show you how simple it is, I have created here a data point, not only a KNX, but also a web user interface data point. And I've linked it also with BACnet in all directions. You see this data point called value ASM can be parameterized this way that you say, okay, on web user interface, I would like to see the value, but also change the value, display and set. On KNX is also an in and output, so communication in both directions. And on BACnet, it's a value which can be read by BACnet, but also can be changed, means written into KNX by BACnet. And of course, also to web UI. So on three levels, complete communication in both directions. And you did it here also practically. And I show you a bit later because this BACnet viewer is a software to see what's going on the BACnet side. And you see in the web user interface, we have the same value as on BACnet and on the group monitoring in the KNX world, it means in the ETS. And this is really simple to create. So I can create dedicated data points to be connected to BACnet, but all other, let me say, internal data points of the application controller can be also easily enabled for BACnet access or communication. The freely programmable logic I mentioned already, it's similar or more or less the same like the logic controller ABAS 121. It's one ASM in principle. So you select the automation ASM. At the first glance, very simple. You have only one button to configure this automation. What does it mean, automation? It's your own freely programmable logic, whatever it means. By clicking on configure automation, you open the worksheet you might remember from the logic controller ABAS. And it is in principle the same. There you create your own logic, whatever you want with the existing modules. There are also a lot of logical functions inside, like logic, like comparison, like mathematical functions, PID controller, and more. You create it here inside this automation ASM, go back to the ETS and integrate it in your complete functionality you have to do together with the application controller. But I show you this as well. Yeah. IBAS tool, ABB IBAS tool. Is there any connection between application controller and ABB IBAS tool? Yes, we have a very simple one, but useful one, let's say. The way we support here this component via IBAS tool is like in the security panel GMA, assessing the web user, the integrated web server, web user interface in this case. So by starting the IBAS tool and activating the IP KNX IP devices view, we detect all connected KNX IP devices in our system. You select ACS 121 or 111, and then you have a button here. If you select this device, open website means you go into the web user interface. You open via the IP address the web user interface. It's also possible to read out the IP address via the ETS. And type this address into a browser and you have the same effect finally. But if you do not have any ETS, it's the simplest way to get access via the IBAS tool. That's all. Any simulation, any testing, any whatever functions, we do much better in the web user interface because we have such an environment directly in the web user interface. A few words regarding the hardware. It's a DIN radio device, as you can see. What we need is an external power supply, either via the 24 volt here on the lower left side, 20 volt, 24 volt DC, or, and you see here on the upper right side, the Ethernet, the LAN connection, in brackets PoE, so also power over Ethernet can be used to energize this component. But we need external energy supply, not possible to take directly from the KNX only. So two options. And the LAN connection is not only for power over Ethernet, has further, let me say, connections of course, to BACnet, we need this. To web user interface, we need this connection. Typically, it's all over IP. Very important is to use it during the commissioning as a direct and fast ETS download of the application. Because there's a lot of, let me say, information we have to download after our programming using the standard way via the twisted pair is possible, but takes a lot of time. We talk about more than 5 minutes, 6, 7 minutes, and more maybe, depending on the amount of intelligence you have programmed. Not very, let me say, user-friendly, so using the direct IP is less than a minute, so really recommended. It's a feature in the ETS to activate direct IP download if available, and in such a component, we have this direct IP connection. LEDs to see LAN and KNX communication and connection, and the on LED is normally constantly on, green. After download, after startup, it's blinking for maybe around 1 minute. This time you have to accept. You have no access to this component via web user interface and no function, but after this time, on LED should be constantly green and then everything is fine. I mentioned already that we have time functions, and time functions are, yeah, of course, related to an internal on clock at all, means we need internal time. There's internal clock. The internal clock we can adjust, of course, different ways I will explain. Yeah, the hardware, I think we can skip this more or less, as it's clear. We have two components available, one without BACnet interface, ACS 111, and 121 with BACnet interface, already mentioned. Some words regarding the performance of the device in terms of quantity. These specific modules, ASMs, are 500 in total we have. 500 in one device, but not for each 500 if you want, but a bit limited regarding scheduler, time functions 15, the central automation functions related to the boiler chiller interface and the heating cooling circuit controller are limited to 15. Very powerful modules, software modules. And the so-called trend loggers, means storing data from the past, is limited to 50, but we can store inside the component up to 3 years data. So it's not anywhere via the cloud. It's really storing data in the component. We have up to 2000 group objects, KNX group objects, plus 4 for communicating date and time or receiving date and time. And to this, you can assign up to 16,000 group addresses. So this is really a powerful component, but nevertheless, if it's not sufficient, it might be necessary to have a second device, and that's possible. BACnet objects, 500 in one device, and 5 parallel accesses via web user interface. Yeah, if you use this automation ASM, like ABAS, ABAS has 5,000 logic elements, here it's only 1,000. So it's a bit limited in capacity, but still okay. The main topic will be not freely programmable logic. You use mainly, I think, the ASMs, but also, as mentioned, you have here the chance to do it. And inside the ETS, you find also an overview how much you have used already from these available maximum elements. Components are available since last week, so on stock, including all software you need, all documentation. Remember, one version without and one with BACnet interface. Yeah, and if you go to our homepage, you will find everything you know from other components. So have a look, including the manual. Don't worry, it's only 500 pages. No, yeah, really, it's 500 pages, but every function, of course, is explained in detail. Only the automation part means the ASM automation. This is more or less the ABAS is around 150 pages. So, but very good documentation to get explained everything if necessary. Yeah, last slide before I come to a real demonstration. Let's go further to the ETS. We have, of course, a KNX device. We have an ETS application. It works with ETS5 and finally only. I will explain why. So ETS5 is a condition. And again, I would like to emphasize communication is via twisted pair, so to all other KNX devices, not via IP. So it's not KNXnet IP protocol. We are running really twisted pair KNX protocol. Fast ETS download via Ethernet, I mentioned already. The time function or the clock internal we need can be synchronized in three ways. Either via BACnet, via KNX, but also now, and this is required of course, via network time protocol. So from any time server on internet or on your network at all, it can be synchronized as well. Yeah, and all the functions we have to parameterize. And you have already seen here also a preview, what we are looking right now in, is not related in the, or not inside the parameter view, but in the so-called DCA, device configuration app. This is an additional, let me say, feature now from the KNX organization in the ETS to integrate external software, which might be necessary for a product, directly in the ETS, in order to have not these numerous external plugins in use, which are more complicated to maintain and always different and so on. So it's a new concept, and we use this, we have to use this here in our new application controller, and it works fine, you will see. But this DCA is an additional principal software file you have to download from the KNX online shop, from the homepage of the KNX organization via your account, will be imported in the ETS, and then it's working. Okay, let's show it practically. I share now my desktop, go into the ETS. Here we are, I've opened already the ETS, ETS 5, and there are some further components, not only the application controller inside, but you see here ACS 1-to-1. I have used, of course, the application controller with BACnet to show you more. If you go down, you see group object, channels, and parameters, not completely new, but then DCA as a further block you can activate. Yeah. And the DCA, how to import this, just for your information, if you go to the main page here, on the lower right side, you have, maybe you remember this from your own ETS, used already, so-called apps. There are some apps from the KNX organization, also apps from ABB, and also here my device configuration app for the application controller ACS. So you can import this after you have downloaded it from the homepage, via your account, and install this app, and then it's available. But you need this, otherwise you cannot parameterize the application controller. And the DCA concept is only supported from ETS 5, not ETS 4 anymore. So no chance to work with ETS 4 anymore. So let's have a look. I have here a not programmed and not adjusted application controller. You see the first group objects are related to date and time, not more. I go now to the DCA, and you come to an environment which is dedicated to the application controller. So what do we see here on the left side? I can keep it like this. All ASMs we have at the moment, so it's a kind of library, with at the moment 17 different modules, intelligent modules, with totally different functions. That's the actual status. Maybe in future we will change this here, we add more. This is not impossible, we will see. But first of all, we have this automation, which is logic controller in principle, value more or less to create data points. Yeah, and if I would like to have a value, I take it, drag and drop, and position it here on my worksheet, either directly in this default view, but on the lower left side, you see I can structure this. I show it directly later in the next component where I've already done something to have a better overview. You can, for example, create some floors here, which are related to your real installation, and to have a better overview to all these modules you are positioning here. Link is simple to have any access to any IP address, homepage, or any email account, just to send something out. The room module I will show to you, representing functions in the room. We can change room set points easily now with a module. And here are the four ASMs related to these intelligent hardware boiler chiller interface and heating cooling circuit controller, where we have the superior software necessary to create this complete solution. Maybe at the end, I give you a small impression what is behind. changing between heating and cooling, depending, for example, depending on outside temperature. Here's a scheduler based on web UI change or based on BACnet change. So more or less the same three times, but operating mode on off and temperature scheduler can be created. And last but not least, these trends, this data logger. Now I go to a really program component only to show you a bit more. This was the first view only. So I go here. You see the parameter is nothing more or less, only telegram limitation. I have to go to the DCA. It will be opened. Sorry, it's the wrong one. This one here. Okay, no problem. I can confirm this. So now I have selected a device which is already programmed. You see, I have also here a structure. So I have some various functions here on top in this block, then followed by first floor and ground floor. And in the basement down there is also something. And in the ground floor, I have created a further structure with a classroom number one. So I started here to create a kind of school solution, not yet complete, but I think I will work step by step on this, but I can show you already a bit. I have already the first training boards and can create something in reality here. Yeah. Good. So you have seen, I can select from the left these modules. If you have selected a module, let's take one. You click on this, then you have on the right the parameters. So in this case, it's a so-called a component or an ASM allowing to change all different set points for cooling and heating from comfort, standby, economy to building protection or whatever. For both heating and cooling means 8 set points I can adjust here and make them accessible via web UI to be changed later in the web user interface. So at the moment I use only cooling comfort and heating comfort. Initial programming to 24 degrees, cooling comfort and heating comfort. So I have programmed here also in the room temperature controller, two different set points for heating and cooling. Let's take another one. For example, let's take the trend. In one trend module, I can create up to 5 trends. So 5 trends can be visualized. I have selected here 4. For outside temperature, control value classroom 1, room temperature classroom 1, and control value teacher's room. So here I would like to assign these values from outside components, how to do this. And now I click here on the linking view for internal connection. So you see something appears which you might remember from the logic controller ABAS. I have these 4 inputs for the trends, nothing visible, but there's a plus icon and I can enable here something. So I have done the following. I have chosen 4 value ASMs. The value ASMs are then available on the KNX side via group objects, assigns the right group addresses from the other components. And now I send it to the trend ASM to be stored and visualized later in the web user interface. Yeah. So outside temperature, status, heating, classroom 1, and so on is available in the group objects. Let's have a look. I go to group objects now and let's have a look to outside temperature. It's here. So this is the connection to the real, let me say, outside temperature coming from any other component, typically from a weather station. And will be here connected to the trend to be stored and again and to be displayed in the web user interface. So this is an internal connection between one ASM value, in my case, outside temperature, to the trend. If you have a look, you see here a further connection with a plus icon. I can open this. If I click here, I use the outside temperature. I can remove this here just to have a better overview. I use the outside temperature not only for recording in my trend. I need it only for changing between heating and cooling mode, because this is depending on outside temperature in my case. To show you, I can click on this ASM and find here the right parameters on the right. So change over based on outside temperature, over 24 degrees, it's a cooling mode because it's hot outside, and below 17, it's heating mode. And furthermore, I need the outside temperature for controlling my heating circuit, for what circuit ever, I don't know at the moment, because also depending on outside temperature, I have to control the supply or the flow temperature for the dedicated heating circuit. That's also an important parameter, not the only one. You see here, room control values are also integrated. I'll show it later. But one further intelligence, and if I open here the intelligence or the parameter of this ASM heating distribution circuit, you find on the right a lot of options to be parameterized. Yeah. So in principle, what is the actual situation regarding the circuit? Sorry, no details at the moment. It takes a bit more time to explain this in detail, but in principle, the intelligence, the superior software intelligence in the ACS for the HCCS, the heating cooling circuit controller. So we have internal communication or connection via this linking view and connecting the sockets with each other. To communicate externally, I need still the group objects or maybe the value ASM, which helps me to create a group object if not accessible directly and to assign group addresses for further communication. Going back to the overview, we come to the elements again. Maybe one final one before I go to the web user interface. The room ASM, very important. I click here on teacher room. And on the right, you have, again, a lot of parameters. In principle, here I adjust what is reality in my room regarding the hardware, the cooling heating hardware. Do I have a fan coil unit, a split unit? Do I have floor heating, radiator, whatever? In my case, I have only created a fan coil unit with continuous fan control, means 0 to 10 volt output for the fan. That's what I have also here in my boards. I would like to display the room set point. Controller can switch on and off. Heating cooling mode, I would like to see, and the operating mode. Comfort, standby, night mode, whatever. But if you see, you can also say, no, no, I would like to change this also from the web user interface. Then you say display and set. Huh? So things like this are possible, as well as changing here the room set point. It's also possible. But at the moment, I display it only. Yeah, and if you go back to the group objects, you see then immediately for my teacher room, I have to get all these values. Yeah, I have integrated also here CO2 and humidity measurement because I have a CO2 sensor in the room. I would like to display in the room ASM in the web user interface, so I have to assign here the group address. Yeah? Plus, I would like to see the control value for the fan and valve and so on. Well, you see. We have some group objects now then in the application controller. Remember, up to 2,000 are possible, plus a 4 here for date and time. So the school director enabled everything, so you see a lot of connections possible, but it's a bit more just to show you something. Good. So one important point, anytime I change anything in my program, my adjustment here, immediately these information appears, project data has changed on the upper right side, you see it here. Please save the project before device programming download. We are at the moment in the DCA, which is part of our ETS, but still a bit separated. So means we have to store or to save our programming directly here in the DCA by using this save button on the upper left side. Doing this, this information disappears because now it's stored and I can safely create or undo my application download and it will be downloaded, also my changes here. So keep this in mind later if you might work practically also with this component. So the first information, how you work in the ETS with our application controller. Allow me to go now directly to the web user interface. So what I did here more or less is not complete, but the first step to show functions in a maybe school project. So how to assess it? Remember, we can take our IBUS tool. I have it already opened. So if you click on IP devices and all KNX IP devices will be visualized. And if I click on all, I'm now connected to the ABB network here in my office. you get more KNX NetIP devices from other rooms, colleagues who are working with this. You see different components. But I'm only interested in the application controller ACS121, and there are three. Okay, I know already this is mine here, because the MAC address is a unique address also written on the device. And by clicking on this and here open website, you will be lead to a browser, and the IP address 10.49.121.13 will be taken to open the web user. I did it already because I synchronized all the functions already, so allow me to go directly to the view. And this will be shown after you have started this, after you have logged in. So it's not automatically for anybody visible, because if you have access to the network, you might go into this web user interface and change something, which is not, of course, acceptable. No, we have here admin. I'm just logged in as administrator with a password. We have four levels, administrator, expert, user, and viewer. And for each, you can adjust in the ETS what is accessible per module, what can be done, only viewing, but also changing. So you can structure this a bit. But of course, I would like to do and show everything. So I'm logged in as an administrator. And now you see exactly what you have created already in the ETS, the structure, the navigation menu on the left. And in each block, the ASMs you have created inside the ETS. At the first glance looks the same, but there's more behind. You can jump directly also if you have a big structure, for example. Good, so I'm online now, so connected to my small Climate Echo installation here. I show you now something together with the program versions, alpha functions here. So one very simple ASM is a so-called link ASM. It's nothing else but a link to a URL, to an IP address, or to a mail account. And what I did here, I have a link for the manual of the application controller. By clicking on this, it goes directly to the manual on our homepage. Okay, so could be possible to have this manual in the background or email address. I have made here one value ASM, just data point with the outside temperature. Remember, that was shown in the group object view. And I have here a potentiometer on one board to simulate this. So at the moment, I have 10 degrees outside. I can change this to a higher temperature. Takes a bit time to synchronize or to update because there's an internal cycle time, but you see very soon it goes up. It's now 37 degrees outside. And if you look to the left here, heating, cooling, change over. It indicates present mode cooling because I've set over 24 degrees, it's cooling mode. To prove this, I go directly into a room. I have created a lot of rooms here. I go now to the teacher's room. So now I'm in the ASM room for the teacher room, and I have, remember, only enabled here the FENCOR unit. It's the only solution I have, but I have also enabled presence detection. I have enabled also window contact, you will see, but have a look operating mode cooling here. I'm the cooling mode. So I can go back and change this again. Okay, I don't have to go back. I can go directly, but takes the time to change. But you see after a short time, it goes to heating because it's below 17 degrees heating, you see. Yeah, and the room set point is 18 degrees. The room temperature at the moment 16. What does it mean for my FENCOR unit? It has to run and has to open the valve. So I'm in the heating mode. Fan is running with speed 55%, and the valve is opens the same level. So if I increase now my set point, I can do it here because I have here room control unit. You see, now I'm using set point 21 degrees. Okay, room temperature is not changing. It goes to maximum speed and maximum valve opening. So you see directly what happens in your room. Later you will see I can also change something. Let's open the window. I have programmed here also window function, means opening the window, it goes to frost mode and showing here 7 degrees. Let's have a look. So I open now the window. It's also graphically visible here. You see the window is open and 7 degrees set point, resulting in switching off the Fanker unit in order to have no heating to outside. I close the window again and it goes back to the former mode. That's clear. Good. Fun further information here, you see automatic mode for the fan, means depending on control value, it adjusts the speed. The room control unit I have installed here allows me to go to manual mode and I switch off to zero manually. Means I'm in the manual mode shown here. Fan speed is zero and also valve is closed. Yeah. So it's a function I have here. And going back goes again. I have here, for example, a scheduler. Let's have a look to the scheduler. At the moment, we are in comfort mode. You can see it here in the teacher's room. I'm in the comfort mode. Operating mode comfort means set point maybe in heating 21 degrees. Let's open the scheduler. So then it opens here. In principle, very simple scheduler to adjust a weekly timer for changing between the different operating modes, maybe in all rooms. You can create some exceptions, some special days, or you can have a kind of yearly calendar to assign a time program for a dedicated day. But let's do it here. Today we are on Wednesday. I would like to have standby mode. I take here the block standby, and now I have a look to the time. It's 9:43 right now, but 9:44, 5:45. I adjust. Sorry, here 9. Okay, you can do it also this way here. 9:54. I would like to go to standby mode in all my rooms, in all my classrooms in the school. You do nothing else but this. Confirm it here by closing. And now we have to wait some seconds until it changes over to standby here. You will see it. But just a moment, but I show you something else. You see here automatic mode. I have the option here to change to manual mode to switch off on my room temperature control unit. Yeah. And you see it's now in the manual mode. Off, everything off. This is the way I programmed it here. I go back to automatic mode, and of course, it works. Good. I've created also a logic in the ABA ACE part. Finally, maybe I show this to you. I have created a logic, very simple one. I show you here, automation ASM. What did I do? If I click on this, you see, first of all, nothing, but can have a look more or less to this logic. And what did I do? I compared, created a comparator. So I compare a value with a room temperature. So my idea here is in German schools, you can say, okay, if it's too hot in the classroom, then school is off because it's too hot. There's no cooling normally in classroom. So if the temperature is over 26 or whatever you adjust here, then I get an information. It's a comparator, nothing else, but can be used, for example, for any further activities. So this is not an ASM available directly. I have to create it by my own. And I can show you, I increase the outside temperature again. So to see that this logic is working. So it takes some seconds until the the room temperature, not the outside temperature. This was my fault. This is from the classroom. I have to do it here, just a moment. Indicating, okay. So 100 degrees, okay, not realistic. But you see, true is the output socket, means the logic which is finally out of this logic I've created as a result. Yeah, okay. Not more, not less. As you see, it's here, heat. I have called it heat. Now I've changed the temperature again. Let's have a look to, yeah, it's just below. Yeah, 26, of course, it's false again. So, and last topic here in the web user interface before I go finally to the BACnet integration. I have here in the basement, maybe there is my heating system, my boiler and so on, all my mechanic, the so-called heating distribution circuit, ASM. I open this as well, and we have now a bit more technical view. Not everything is assigned at the moment with group addresses and telegrams. You see all visible data points here, which have a rotating blue circle here, are not synchronized, have no actual value received. So it's not something I can show, but I have here a further topic, supply temperature. And what does it mean? Here you have the heating curve. Heating curve depending on outside temperature. So how hot shall be the water, the flow temperature in the circuit, depending on outside temperature. You can change it here. I can update here. I can change the curve. So for any adaption, you see I've changed now here at this point, it's number 3. Whatever I do will be changed here. So it's possible now for the caretaker, for the technical staff to change this curve easily via the web user interface. Yeah. One further function I would like to show to you, maximum room control value. To optimize the water temperature in the circuit, not only the outside temperature is important, but also the current control values of the different rooms behind, different actuators with a different control value. At the moment, 0%, I have assigned only, let's have a look, the classroom, which is 0, it's closed at the moment, and the teacher's room. So I go to the teacher's room again and have some action. So we are in cooling. I increase the room temperature to have cooling active. Just a moment to see a real control value. And this logic inside this heating cooling circuit controller ASM detects the maximum value out of different connected controllers to react correctly. So it means the highest value is important to adjust the right supply temperature. So it's 7% now. Let's make it a bit hotter, but it increased a bit because we have not such a big difference between room and temperature and set point temperature, but it will change in a moment, please. So you see, now it's hotter in the room, higher speed, 100%, or a bit less. To have a value in between again. And at the moment, I close this here. You see now it's 60%, okay. So the highest value is 60%, teacher's room, because the classroom, the other one which is connected, and many more in practice, has 0. Let's have a look. Supply temperature, and it shows me it takes a maximum room control value, which is in my case 60%. A further parameter to optimize the right flow temperature, or to supply the right flow temperature in this dedicated circuit. And many more functions. But I stop right now to show you finally the BACnet integration. I keep it open. I go in parallel now to my BAC viewer, BACnet viewer, BACeye so-called. I have opened already. I've started already, and this BACeye is a viewer to detect all connected BACnet devices and all data points behind. And my application controller is a BACnet device, so detect it. On the right, you see all connected data points to BACnet, which are some you might remember. For example, the CO2 value of the classroom, the set point of the classroom, or here the window function. Let's have a look. Classroom 1 status, window status close. To show you that there is a real communication, I open now the window in the classroom. It was closed. It's still closed, obviously. No, I have to refresh here only because it's not a live update. So former situation was closed. Now I update here. And now the window is open. It's correct. I've opened the window. I close the window again. And it will be updated as well after refreshing. Close. So communication from KNX via application controller to Bugnet. I can change all the values from Bugnet to show you this. I click here on, let's have a look. Set point, classroom number one, 19 degrees. Is it correct? We go back to the web user interface. Yes, room set point, you see it here, 19 degrees. Okay, let's change it. Yeah, it's a more a viewer software, not a powerful software, but it's possible to do. I click on this. And I can change it here. I type in 20. This is the value I would like to change. I send it from Bugnet to KNX in this case, also to the web user interface, of course. It's done. Let's have a look. And you see room set point is 20 now. Okay, that's all for this Bugnet communication at the moment, and as mentioned, it's very simple to assign it to Bugnet, and then it's available. Okay, so we have reached more or less the end. I go back. So I hope you got an impression how it works. Not, of course, all details, not possible, but to get a feeling how it works. We have started the first practical trainings now with the application controller, and more will come. But we are working step by step on this. Final words, as always, preview to the next events we have here in Heidelberg, which is very soon the certified tutor course. Not far anymore, so still some seats available, but we have already a lot of persons for both courses. So the tutor course and standard course in October. So one option, and the basic course, the additional basic course we have this year in November, also possible to attend if you require or you want, or anybody of your team or your customers. And next webinar, very soon, in 1 week, I have sent out the invitation already yesterday, yes. So it's a push voice control. So totally different application, but also something nice to communicate, to talk to the KNX system is a message. And we have a quite good solution now also on the market, now available. So this will be done then in exactly 1 week. And the invitation should be received by you, and please join if you want. Again, look to the chat, nothing at the moment. So then I say thank you so much for your participation. We will send you, of course, the video and the slides of this webinar, most probably next week, but you will get it very soon. See you next time. Thank you and bye-bye. Ciao.